Would the congregation please stand?
Okay, just sort myself out. Clickety click click. Aha! Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back. I'm Riccardo. This is RCJ Music Workshops. Thanks for logging in. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks to all the wonderful support I've had over the last few weeks. Let's say a few hellos. Hi, Laura. Hi, Juan. Hi, Sarah. Hi, Sheila. Hi, Zdena, the wifey. Andrea, I think that's you there as well. Right, yes. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gone to stay. Ain't no sunshine when she goes, and this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. And I know. Hey, y'all, live your faithful love, but ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. Sunshine when she goes, and this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away. Time she goes away. Lovely.
Thank you. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you all. We have come here today to remember before God Riccardo, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be cremated, and to comfort one another in our grief. So as we are, let us pray. God of all consolation, your Son, Jesus Christ, was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Look with compassion on your children in their loss. Give to troubled hearts the light of hope, and strengthen in us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Riccardo was a singer, so I'm holding great hopes for the volume I'm going to hear during our hymn this afternoon. We sing, "The Lord's My Shepherd."
Thank you.
seated as we listen to Memories of Riccardo.
Daddy was the best singer, and he really was very nice. I made a bracelet for him when he came back home, so he passed away. One of the teachers bought me a memory box and a special book that's at school, and I have one at home here with me. I put that bracelet in that box the teacher gave me, and I weaved a heart for him, and I'm going to put it on his coffin now. Dance in front of me, he used to play with me, and he bought lots of toys for me. We went to McDonald's together. I'm going to have a bracelet to remember Daddy, and I'm going to wear it forever. Daddy bought flowers for Mummy and chocolates for her. Daddy was dead when it arrived at our house, so Mummy was happy and sad. We miss him, Valentina.
What a man we've lost, with the biggest heart, the greatest and funniest brother, a devoted, loving husband, and mostly the best daddy ever. I still can't believe and don't understand what's happened. My only explanation is God must have been really sad and needed Rick to sing for him, comfort him, and make him laugh. That's what Rick has been doing all his life. He gave his all to his family, friends, and all the people he met, worked with, and entertained. I just want to close my eyes and see you all around and Rick singing for all of us. Looking back to the time we met, I see this young man who was a bit lost in his life and just tried to find himself. He was like a child who entered a room full of grown-ups and wanted everyone's attention. And also, he was a bit annoying. He always brought light, energy, and fun. As a couple, we had our ups and downs, but there was always so much love between us. Rick was a front man, not just in a band, but in our family, always supportive, protective, and proud. When we found out about our little addition, Valentina, he was a bit scared, but absolutely fantastic from the beginning. Even during the pregnancy, he used to sing to her. And they had this unbreakable bond, which just grew stronger. He would give everything to her. He could be in the middle of something, but always had time for Valentina. I'm so sorry, darling, you can't see her grow up. That was your biggest fear. You tried to catch her in slow motion, but never expected this to happen. I'm so angry you left us here with hearts broken in pieces. But now you fought till your last breath. Only thing I can promise you today, I'll try to bring her up the best way I can. I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of the man you've become and what you've achieved. You've done an amazing job with your music and songwriting. You've made an impression on people, and lots of them got together and made your dream come true. I'm so happy and lucky I was on this journey with you. Thank you for nearly 12 years full of emotions, laughter, and mostly love. You made me feel loved all the way, and that's what life is about. I will miss you every day. Rest in peace, moi Alaska, moi Dilly, love you always. Hope one day we'll find each other again.
I tell you about my brother that you don't already know. Well, Riccardo Carmelo James Criscenti, as you know, was born 14th of June, 1976. He was known affectionately by many other names, or some of you probably have your own for him, Rickard Dick, JTH was ours, Jabba the Hutt, many other ones. My parents were absolutely ecstatic to have a boy. Rick was a very beautiful baby, blonde, blue-eyed, cherub-like, cute and cuddly and very good-tempered. As a boy, he loved the usual things, cars, trains, cartoons, sometimes football. We'd watch Saturday morning TV together. We'd play cops and robbers, and we would push each other around in our pedal car, shooting cap guns. Joe and I used to force him to push us, the most actually, and would make him go and get things from upstairs by suggesting we timed him, and many other things that sisters do to annoy their brothers. He loved to try and do stunks, which were obviously stunts, but he'd call them stunks. He'd get little ramps and try and jump his bikes over them. We started going to dance and drama lessons at the Star School of Dance and Drama in Watford. Rick had a number of parts in Carousel and The Music Man and in dance shows. He played on that cuteness even then, really. He was happy on stage. Music, although it featured in the early part of his life through shows and him learning the clarinet and a bit of violin, it wasn't really until he was in his 20s that his true love of music began to show, and he started to sing, play the guitar and write. School wasn't his favourite place to be. He hated writing, homework and preferred getting laughs. Teachers used to say, "We can't stay angry at him for long when he smiles his cheeky smile," which actually has been his personality all along. We as a family will love to wind each other up, do impressions of people, and enjoyed laughing even in the saddest moments like this. My brother had, and my sister also, still has an amazing ability to impersonate people. Rick had a repertoire of impersonations he did when he was younger, including an impression of my dad's dad, Buongiorno Man. Breaking wind in our house was always funny. Still is, but I'll spare you the details of our jokes and Rick's torture of Scooby the cat. He was always loving, but really could wind us up at times. I remember I threw a fork at him once, which ended up hitting him in the forehead, narrowly missing his eye. My sister and Rick had also had a fight over sharing the truck, they had one piece each, and ended up with Rick throwing it at my sister, cutting just above her eye on a trip to hospital. In fact, my mum said at that point, which I just remembered, she said, "Oh, social service have been calling us. We've been to the hospital so many times in the last few weeks." Rick used to impersonate Elvis Presley, using other impersonators' sets at the time. The spiel went a bit like this. "Elvis never used to talk. He used to sing everything. Elvis, we got to win this race. We're going to win this race. And Elvis, we want some lemonade. Lemonade, that cool, refreshing drink. And so Rick used to do this. So every time someone mentioned Elvis or lemonade, we'd sing that. He also did the Elvis style dancing, which I'm not going to do, which he used time and again to entertain people as he got older. My sister also used to do Elvis. Perhaps you can ask her for a rendition later. None of the family escaped either, with impersonations of my dad's dancing, my singing and moodiness, my sister's singing and flirting, and my mum's talking and laughing. He mainly said she laughed like Jafar from Aladdin, if you know the film, which is a bit like a wheeze, so when he's in the cave of wonders, if you know the film. I actually can't really do it, but it went a bit like this. You kind of put your teeth in and you wheeze like mutton, but I can't do that. So feel free to have a go yourself. Poor mum also used to tolerate my brother blowing cigarette smoke through her hair, affectionately known as the nest. from behind her without knowing. Oh, I can't laugh. As her hair was curly and back brushed, the smoke used to come out in wisps through every gap the smoke could find. It looked really funny, and even my mum would sit there and also laugh at it. Shall I do that? Are you sure? Okay. One thing my brother never lived down was that in homage to one of Prince's videos, he made a baseball cap with chains hanging down from it. It was actually pretty clever for his age, but the chains were really, really thick ones. And he used to ride his Raleigh chopper bike, pretending it was a motorbike, wearing that hat. Somewhere he still had that hat, and we have the photo as evidence. Joe and I still laugh out loud whenever we think about this hat. Among many other anecdotes, one time Joe and Rick wanted to make salt and vinegar flavoured chips, and were using the deep fat fryer. They thought, cleverly, that they would add the salt and vinegar into the fryer, which of course naturally created a bit of a fire. While it was dangerous, so instead of trying to put the fire out, Rick ran through the house screaming like a banshee, "Fire, fire, everybody out of the house!" Which amused my dad no end, actually. Reading this back now, it doesn't seem that funny, but it still brings a smile to our faces. As a teenager, he was a rebel, really, at times avoiding school, smoking with friends and listening to music. He pimped the boot of my dad's Vauxhall Astra estate with massive speakers so he could blast out dance tunes, and often the sound of the bass would arrive before he did. Even from a young age, he would help at the restaurant and knew how to charm people. Once school had ended, Dad was worried about his future and told him he should really come into the family business to learn a trade. My brother always had the ability to effortlessly turn a hand to anything and be good at it, especially entertaining people. Working in the restaurant as both a waiter and chef at the family restaurants Alfonso's and then at Bonapasta, he was well loved by all customers. He found working in the family business really difficult, as he didn't enjoy working at the time when all his friends were out at the weekend, and so burned the candle at both ends. It was very hard at times for him working in the family business, and eventually he left and began working for Jason and Christina at Golf to Golf, where again he turned a hand to many things and used his personality to sell. In the background, throughout his time in restaurants and at Golf to Golf, he began singing. Robbie Williams' Angels and Lionel Richie All Night Long were among his first tracks. This developed a lot during the time he worked at Bonapasta, as every weekend evening, Rick would DJ and sing, and the waiters at Bonapasta even made the local press under the headline, "Stripping Waiters Do the Full Monty." I'll leave that to your imagination. Arturo, my dad's business partner at Bonapasta, said to us recently that he would need a whole weekend to tell us all the mischief they got up together. I can believe that, actually. If he went out for the evening, my brother, and there was live entertainment or a charity fundraiser where there was a microphone to hand or an opportunity to perform, Rick would have no qualms in delivering an impromptu performance, often nailing it so well that the crowd always wanted more and oftentimes put the other performer to shame. Rick was always generous and cared a lot for people, and used his singing and his abilities to do this, beginning with helping out at the Gateway Club with Adam, spending time with young people with additional needs in his mid-teens. It's one of the reasons why we picked the Electric Umbrella charity. He also raised money for Dens and would happily sing at anything for charity. A highlight of this for him was singing at the Pepper Show, two events of which were directed by Paul. He sang as Robbie Williams, Elton John in a Marie Antoinette dress, and Macklemore, among other tracks. His love of music and singing ability continued to gain momentum, and he was in a number of bands, such as Invisible Dog. Yes, we always laughed at that name. Belting out tracks like Ruby and other rock songs. At some time about then, he also had singing lessons and learned to sing songs like Gethsemane from Jesus Christ Superstar, tracks by Tom Jones, show tunes, Dean Martin, and his music taste expanded a lot. Having been in the soul band myself at university, I'd always said to him, while he was in Invisible Dog, why don't you sing something that will really show off your vocal range? And I was personally really made up for him when he began singing with Soul Enforcement Bureau and saw him use the fullness of his singing range. It was a real highlight in my life, being able to dip in that band playing sax with him singing. Watching him firsthand manage the crowd. I always loved watching him perform, and the last time I saw him was with Let's Get It On. The Motown experience. They mainly perform at private functions, but he was again fantastic. For about the last 5 years, Rick sung in care homes and he was a professional musician and DJ. The idea for singing in care homes was given to him by his friend Kev, and it was the first step to him being able to become a fully professional musician. Over the years, he had already begun to write songs, and before he died, he was in the middle of a fantastic songwriting course doing collabs. Sorry, Rick. And he had made his own recording studio at home. He made many, many people happy singing live during lockdown to keep people's spirits up. Rick was always a bit of a split personality, really, having the incredible ability to lead people and entertain them, while at the same time being someone who was sensitive, creative, deep, a thinker, and could be very insular, quiet, and melancholy. He was able to truly express himself in his songwriting. Rick was also a loyal friend. He liked to be there for people. However, if you were his friend, watch out, because for sure he had a way of winding you up or impersonating you. One of the unique ways he showed his affection was winding you up. I'm sure that his friends Darren, Marco, Kev, Wayne, Owen, Lee, Dean, Adam, the football team, bands, etc., will tell their own stories of how he would wind them all up. Their good times of how he would lead them by saying, "Guys, we're going out, out!" Not in, I can't do it as well as him, obviously. And their adventures. In the last 12 years, since he met Zdena, they had Valentina and made their own lives together. It has been lovely to see my brother truly become himself in both his home and work lives. Although he loved his singing and DJing, professionally in care homes, in bands, songwriting and events on his own, his family were his number one priority. And although lockdown was very difficult, it was a time when he was able to bond with Valentina, and they as a family were able to share good times and bad. He was looking towards a bright future. We all were as a family, after the last few years of loss and bereavement, probate, COVID. We were also looking forward, looking towards enjoying our families together. For reasons none of us may have never known, someone who still had so much to give was taken from us far too early. While his music will live on, we will all have a Rick-shaped hole which will be difficult to fill with anything else, as he was unique. As we mourn his loss, we can say that for sure, Rick, in the words of Frank Sinatra's song, which he used to sing so amazingly well, "I did it my way," Rick, you definitely did everything your way. We love you so much and miss you every day. Rick would want to be remembered for his zest of life, successful life, for his singing, songwriting, his love for his family and friends, and generous nature, but especially his sense of humour. He was ever the entertainer. As we sit here and then leave this building with the opportunity to continue living our lives in his memory, please remember to live life to the full like Rick did. Grab hold of every opportunity in his memory. We love you so much, Rick. May you rest in peace. Gone, but never to be forgotten.
As we each think of our own memories of Rick and those that have been shared with us, we listen to him singing, "Cry to Me."
So let's do a bit of Solomon Burke. Time to dance. I saw the hustle mine. Whoa!
Now a reading from Holy Scripture. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." But Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except for me. For I came that you may have life and have it abundantly." Now, as I said right at the beginning of this service, we have come here today to do three things. Firstly, to give thanks to God for the life and witness of Riccardo. Secondly, to commend his soul into protection of Almighty God. And thirdly, to comfort one another in our grief as we remember those times which we spent in his company. These last few weeks have been devastatingly sad and painful as we have seen someone so full of life and ambition fall ill and then be snatched from us all too early. Riccardo's unexpected death may well have forced us to face something we don't want to face, our mortality. It's something we know will happen, as it's the only thing apart from taxes that we can be certain of in life. But it is still something we don't like to talk about because we don't really understand it. Many poets have helpfully and unhelpfully shared their understanding on death. But how does this correspond to the Christian understanding of death? Well, for a Christian, death is a part of life. It is a passage through which one must pass in order to feast with Christ at the eternal banquet table. Death is no longer the end, since Christ has banished the powers of death by his death and resurrection and opened for us the gates of heaven. So yes, death is a reality we almost face, but it's not the end. Christ has given us the hope of eternal life, where, as St. John in the book of Revelation tries to show, there'll be no more crying or mourning or pain. And in the reading from Holy Scripture, we again glimpse something of this new reality. Jesus said to his disciples, "I go to prepare a place for you where there are many dwellings." This is not an empty promise. It is the promise of eternal life. A promise Rick knew from his youth, and it's a promise that will leave room for others, both those of another faith or of no faith, to rest with God at the fulfillment of all things. A place where we are reunited with loved ones. A place, I hope, where music plays on. Towards the end of his life, Rick had really found his vocation. He was the happiest with his family and friends, making music and entertaining people. Rick had learnt to live life to the full. He had heard and taken heart of Jesus' message, that he had come so that we might have life and have it in all its fullness. Rick seized the day. His choices might sometimes have raised eyebrows, but he owned them. The scriptures also say elsewhere that there is a time and a season for everything. There was a time to laugh and a time to cry, a time to sing and entertain, and even a time to be quiet, a time to care for his family and a time to be cared for, a time to listen, or not, as the case may be. Likewise, there was a time to love. St. Paul, in his letter to the Corinthians, wrote very powerfully concerning the power of love. For love is arguably the greatest force in the world, especially when we can tangibly feel it. And it was through love that God sent Jesus, his only Son, into the world to save us. God sent his Son to show us the way and to show us that there is nothing to fear in death. For Jesus has conquered the powers of death by his death and resurrection. Today, therefore, as we commend Rick's soul into the protection of Almighty God, trusting in his love for us and for him, and also in the resurrection to eternal life, let us be thankful. For though today is the right time for us to grieve and mourn, for Rick is and will be deeply missed, today can also be a day of celebration, for Rick is now at peace with his Maker. Let us therefore be thankful for all our memories which we treasure. Let us be thankful for all the love and friendship he showed to us. Let us be thankful that he followed his dream and fulfilled his vocation. Let us be thankful for the gift of his life and for all that he achieved. And let us rejoice in the sure and certain hope that Rick is now at rest in the arms of our Heavenly Father. I invite you now to join with me in prayer. Let us pray. God of mercy and Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Rick, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, and for the memories we treasure today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, you promise eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant Rick, as we also remember him. Bring Rick and all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in your mercy on Rick's family and friends and all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness and strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, you are tender towards your children and your mercy is over all your works. Heal any memories of hurt and failure. And give us the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All these are prayers we offer to Father in the words which Jesus himself gave us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We listen to Rick singing, Let's Get It On.
I'll sing this one for the wife. What she likes.
I've been really trying, baby, trying to hold back this feeling for so long. And if you feel like I feel, baby, come on.
Let's get it on.
Ooh. let's get it on. Sugar, let's get it on. We're all sensitive people with so much to give. Understand me, sugar, yeah. Since we've got to be here, let's begin. I love you. Thank you very much.
Would you please stand as we commend Rick to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power, Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Rick to your mercy in the name of Jesus our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you now and forever. Amen. Rick, go forth upon your journey from this world in the name of God the Father Almighty, who created you, in the name of Jesus Christ, who suffered death for you, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who strengthens you. In communion with Mary and all the blessed saints, and aided by the angels and archangels and all the armies of the heavenly host, may your portion be this day in peace, and your dwelling, the heavenly Jerusalem. Amen. So we have entrusted Rick to God's mercy, and we now commit his body to be cremated. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to to dust. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies, that they may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. And may God give you all his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. As you'll see from the back of the order of service, you are all welcome to join the family at Shendish Manor immediately after the service, and then there'll be an open mic later on this evening. If you'd like to make a donation in memory of Rick, going to Riccardo's Big Smiles Fund. Rick is going to sing us out, but a request from the family is that it is about him entertaining. So, if you want to, I think the word was jiggle a little bit, you're welcome to do so as Rick leaves the church. If you want to have some percussion instruments to do so, they're making their way through church for you to make a racket to join in with the entertainment. Let's let Rick send us out.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. You're amazing. I'm singing in private to Valentina, a bit of You're So Beautiful. So until then, take care of yourselves. It's been another amazing hour, as always, but you've all been so amazing. I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. You've been amazing. Thank you so much for the support. Take care of yourselves and each other, and I'll see you next time. Bye.